The mystery family again. Jai Baba to all. Here is my wife Rhoda. Say Jai Baba.
Jai Baba.
Sarosh.
Jai Baba.
Paramro.
Jai Baba.
Mirwan.
Jai Baba.
And Nargesh.
Jai Baba.
Now, one more incident that Nargesh reminded me just now was that in Pune we were going for a drive with Baba. And the car was crowded, so I was a little ahead. Baba was practically next to me. So in order not to discomfort Baba, I was a little ahead. So and at that particular time, some very pretty cyclists, lady cyclists, happened to pass by. And Mirji was all the time, you know, glancing from the corner of his eyes, and so was I. Baba caught us. He said, "What do you mean? What are you doing, you boys?" So I said, "Baba, after all, you are also in these pretty girls." So Baba liked that answer. Now, I told Baba that, "Baba, you are also in these pretty girls. So where is the harm in my staring at them?" That was one thing. Now, Rhoda, you remember something? Shall we start?
Yes.
Rhoda, when was the last you saw Baba?
On the 23rd of December, we saw Baba last. And when the program was over, Baba was looking very pale and he was very tired. And whilst going in, he said that, "I am not this body, I am the infinite ocean of love."
Yes, I remember that.
Those were his last words to us.
I remember that day, Baba called me to his room and wanted to know, even in that bad state of health, whether I felt hurt because he had not called me to stay there. I told Baba, "Baba, please, I really don't feel anything. But I know that you are not well. Please rest and get well soon." And that was also the last I saw Baba, in December 1968, I think, wasn't it?
Yes.
That was the last. Mirwan, you have anything to say?
Yes, sir.
Come along.
Bono kemi nithik lo.
You can't recollect anything?
Whatever it is.
Well, it so happened that after I passed my schooling, there was a student exchange program whereby Indian students go to America and American students come to India. So I had applied to go to America and I was almost selected. And when my selection was almost ready, I wrote to Baba. I told Daddy, who was going to Mir Azad, who would be meeting Baba, I told him to tell Baba whether he would allow me to go to America. So Baba asked Daddy, "Now what is this new thing that he has brought up? Why does he want to go to America now?" So Baba never directly said no. He said, "If I say no, will he be disappointed?" That is what Baba asked Daddy.
Yeah, I remember that.
So Baba did not want to hurt anyone's feelings. So therefore, he could have said no and I would have not gone without question. But not wanting to hurt my feelings, he asked whether I would be hurt if you said no. So Daddy said that, "No, Baba, he will obey what you say." So Baba said, "Anyhow, if he insists on going, then you tell him that before he goes, he should come to Mir Azad and meet me. And I would give him a list of orders before he goes." And of course, when Daddy told me this, I said that because Baba does not will it so, I will not go. And I wrote to the American Field Service that I will not be going to America. And so I canceled my application.
And now we intend to go.
Yes. The advantage of that is that I realize now that if I had gone to America at that time, I would never have become a doctor. For the simple reason that my cousin, who also wanted to become a doctor, went on this American field program, and when she returned, she had lost all interest in studies. So Baba works in different ways. We do not understand the ways, but it's always for our best. So, and had I gone there, Baba would have given me a list of orders, which I would have been bound by for a lifetime. Or, so in that way I got saved. Not only from my career got saved, and not only that, I got saved from a list of orders. Yes.
1 year would be lost.
Yes. And that orders, I know what those orders might would have been, because Mehrwan,
Lubash
of Pakistan had a lot of orders that he should not touch women with lustful intentions, that he should not drink, that he should never gamble, that he should never lie, and this.
Yeah.
And,
so did Homa.
Yes. And once you get the orders, and breaking those orders is not one sin, it's a double sin. So,
it's unforgivable.
So, this is how I got saved from two things. My career got saved, and I got saved from a whole list of orders. Now, if.
You have nothing to say?
Come along.
Nothing?
Baba said. I want to tell you another story about Baba lovers visiting Baba centers. It was one of the summer vacations in the Guru Prasad. I don't remember the exact year. Baba suddenly asked, I was sitting down before Baba, and we had bought tickets for the pictures in the evening. After Baba retired, we decided that I and the other Jimmy Khan was there would go to pictures. Suddenly Baba looks toward us and says that you two go to the Pune center today. Today is Saturday and there's a meeting there, so you go there today. So I said, yes, Baba. And after Baba retired, I suddenly remember that we have bought tickets for the picture show in the evening. But I told Jimmy that since Baba has said this, we must go. So we sold off the tickets and went to Baba center. The first thing that Baba asked us the next morning when we went is, did you go to the center? And he was very happy that we went to the center, and he told us that you should always go to the center. And then he also told the other people around who were there, do you go to the center? So, but sometimes, do you go to the center? When I get the time, do you go to the center? Yes, Baba, but my health is not permitting. So everyone was asked whether he goes to the center. So Baba, and hardly a few said that they went to the center regularly. So Baba then told all of them that you think yourself to be fortunate because you are sitting right in front of me, but thereby you have not gained much. But if you had gone to the center with faith that I was there, you would have got much more than what you have got sitting in front of me. So this is what Baba meant, that I am always there when one or more of my lovers collect in my name, gather in my name. So Baba has always given great emphasis to Baba lovers attending meetings. So this was another very important incident which I recollected.
You try something. Well, if you don't think of a question, if you don't think of something to say, then you must think of a question to ask someone else. You have one choice or the other.
Well, I'll speak a little bit later on.
What are you waiting for?
Let Daddy speak for the present.
No. As soon as it's spontaneous. All spontaneous.
What did you say?
Well, I remember that when we used to break flowers in the morning in Mobo's Hotel, and we used to collect 20 of them and make garlands and send them to Baba, and Baba used to get very pleased. And I also remember, Falu, that you used to go to.
We also used to climb certain trees and. And pluck some jambuls. It's a fruit, a black sort of a fruit. And we used to send them to Baba, and he used to like these fruits of Mobo Hotel. And sometimes my mother used to prepare some good food, which Baba used to like curry and rice, and we used to go and deliver them to Guru Prasad, and there he would always give us something in return, like a mango, like his prasad, something like that. And he used to be happy.
That's all.
He used to be happy.
I recollect another story, a very interesting story.
You are very small.
It does not concern me, but it concerns these women. But I am sure they don't recollect this story, so I'm going to speak out for them. One day, which year was that Hamirpur Sawas, the first Hamirpur Sawas, which you had not attended?
That's a lovely incident.
Which one had you not attended? In which year was it?
Andhra.
Kovur. In which year was it? Do you remember the year?
Yes, 63. That's a
very interesting. In 1963, there was an inauguration of Baba's statue in Kovur, in Andhra Pradesh. And Baba had insisted that, in 1963, there was an inauguration of a Baba statue in Kovur. And a lot of people all over India, Baba lovers, had planned to go there. But it's incidentally, none from Bombay went there, except Gajwani and Sigan Poria and one or two other ladies had gone there. The thing that happened was that very summer, when the Bombay lovers went to Pune for Baba's darshan, Baba sent his own car at the Pune station to bring his lovers immediately at Guru Prasad before going to the hotel. So we had to leave our luggage on the station in charge of a few other people there. And in Baba's car, we went to Guru Prasad. Baba was sitting there in the main Mandali hall. And all the women and all the other, the whole batch was full of women and children. The men only used to come at weekends. So all the women were made to file before Baba, sit down there. And the first question that Baba asked was, did you go to Kovur? No, Baba. Why did you not go to Kovur? He said, Baba, I was not feeling well. Why did you not go to Kovur?
No,
to Kovur, the place where Baba's statue was inaugurated, yes.
It's in Andhra.
So why did you not go to Kovur? Baba, I was not feeling well. Baba, I had heart trouble. So Baba said, you had heart trouble? What would have happened? Worse comes to worse, you would have died. Baba did not lay any importance upon the ill health of that patient, of that Baba lover.
One person said that, Baba, you were not there. And one person said, Baba, you were not there. So Baba said, I was there. Because I was there, I'm telling you, why didn't you all go?
Exactly. So my reason for telling this story is that Baba has never laid emphasis or importance of his lovers being in his physical presence. Baba has said that many times that his true lovers and many of his true lovers are scattered throughout the different corners of the world. They might not have even seen Baba, but yet they love Baba so dearly and they love Baba as he should be loved. So it is not the being in Baba's physical presence which is very important. It is having faith in Baba, attending centers, going to Baba meetings, which is very important. Now, Daddy, I think you have a very good story to tell about this.
About, yes. I recollect that we were with Baba at Guru Prasad and someone brought the news that Baba, one of your very old lovers, that Guru at Bun Garden, and he's crying his heart out there. And he says that Baba has forgotten me, an old lover, and he's got new faces around him now. So Baba called him to the hall, sent word and called him there. And he said, look here, I have not forgotten you, but you seem to have forgotten that I am God. Now show me who is supposed to be new and who is supposed to be old. Are these people who are sitting around me, are they very old and very good and very intimate, the most intimate of the Mandali, he pointed out and said, do you think they are the closest? Do you think he is the closest? Do you think he is the closest? Or is he new? Is he old? It is not that. There are people all around the world who have not seen me and who are carrying out my work. And there are people who will having just heard of me, they will do a tremendous amount of work for my cause. That incident I remember. You've got anything to add, boys? Nargesh, you have something to add to this? Speak on the mic.
As Mehrwan related the incident, we had gone to Hamirpur, and the love for Baba that we had seen there, we saw there, was so wonderful, that experience, that we have never seen anything like it in our whole life. It was absolutely 100% worth the trip. And then we realized why Baba scolded us so much to go to his Hamirpur, where every leaf, even in the dust, we felt Baba all the time. Even a leaf, we could feel Baba there. His presence was so very strong. And he always said that Hamirpur is my heart. And we actually felt what his heart was like.
You want to relate another story?
Yeah, I... It's another story about Baba playing Larisk. This again happened in one of those summer vacations when we used to go to Pune, and I used to go and stand with Baba in the hall where Baba used to play Larisk. Baba often used to say, "Why don't you play?" So I said, "Baba, I don't know. I don't know to play Larisk." So he said that, "Learn and then play." So in the meanwhile, I used to be the card collector. The cards would be thrown on the center. Manli, the Baba lovers would sit around Baba in a circle, and they would throw the cards in the center. And so my duty was to collect the cards, and then at the end of the game, shuffle the cards and deal the cards to each lover. So then at one time, Baba's team was losing, and they had to rub their noses on the carpet. So people in Baba's team used to tell Baba, "Now what is this, Baba? Your team is losing. Now you something, we must win." Usually, almost always, Baba's team used to win. So Baba's lovers in his team used to tell Baba, "Baba, your team is losing. Now you must make your team win. What is this? You are God and your team must win." So then I got an idea. I said, "I am the card dealer. So if I can arrange the cards in such a way that Baba gets the aces, then he will win." And Baba always used to take the aces usually from other people, and then his team used to win. So I said, "Now why not give the aces to Baba so he would win straight away?" So I would collect the aces very slyly, keep them right at the end. And while shuffling, I would just take that pack and put it on the top. And then dealing, I would give the ace to Baba. So Baba would take just one card and say, "Larisk." He would do this. He would not let me deal the cards to others also. He would say, "Larisk." And then he would make them rub their noses. This happened once. This happened twice. Baba then says, "How is this happening all the time? Did you deal properly?" I said, "Baba, the aces were down and I just put them up and I just gave it to you." She said, "No, that will not do. But so play the right game." But he was quite happy that at least his team won 3 times. So that was the story of
Larisk.
Well, anyone else has to say something?
Shall I start? One day Baba drove from Mehrazad to Bombay, and he stopped his car here at Dadar and sent word upstairs that he wanted Jimmy immediately downstairs to drive the car. So I was shaving at that time. I had half a shave, and I put things down and rushed to the car and drove Baba to Ashiana, that is Bridge Candy. Baba was happy at this instant obedience, and it was partly due to my wife pushing me out of the door continuously, "Go, go, go, go." So she was partly responsible for my instant obedience. Another humorous story I remember was at Mahabaleshwar. Baba was not in good health, and everyone was preparing some kind of food program for Baba. So Deshmukh was there, Dr. Deshmukh, my friend, and he and I started talking as to how we should feed Baba to improve his health. So he started with giving him more and more milk, morning, noon and night. I suggested fruits. Then someone suggested butter. And then it went on, and that it was a very big list that we prepared as to how Baba should be fed. And that was presented to Baba the next morning. So Baba read the list and said, this is the amount of food I have perhaps in a whole year. Not as breakfast, lunch and dinner, but what you have done is my food for the whole year. Another story of our doctor is, Dr. Deshmukh, is he used to be given a small packet of butter. We were all given a small packet of butter at Guru Prasad to have on our breakfast with bread. So Dr. Deshmukh, having had his breakfast at the hotel where he was staying, would take the butter, apply it on one slice of bread, but on both the sides to finish the packet. So from that time onwards, he was called Dr. Deshmukh with butter on both sides. Now I think this is more than enough. Now.
Come on, start. The black
portions. Begin.
In Mehrazad, when Baba went to the men Mandli, four servants boy used to come and carry Baba on his chair. So when they came in the morning, Baba asked them one by one how many chapatis they had. So one boy said, I had one chapati. Then the other boy said, I had also one chapati. The third said, I had one chapati. And the fourth one said, I had two chapatis. So Baba was very happy. And then he told them to carry him to the man Mandli. Like that, he used to come every day. He used to come and go from the women Mandli to the men Mandli. And whilst in the evening, Kaka Bariya gave such funny names to these boys, servant boys. And
Because Kaka Bariya gave such names because he could not enunciate or pronounce properly, he had uremia or something.
Yes.
And he gave his own different names.
Yes, that was.
And he gave his own different, Kaka Bariya used to give his own different names to the different boys.
Yes.
Queer sounding names. So Rhoda was now.
So when Baba came to the women Mandli, he always used to call me because I was very. I used to forget all the names, and he used to make me speak the names of all the boys. And women used to prompt me from inside. And one day, like this every day, it went on like this every day. And one day Baba brought nearly 8 boys. And 8 of them had such names unheard of. So when I started to remember the first and the second names, I forgot the third and the fourth, like that. And the women went on prompting from inside, and Baba used to have such laugh and fun.
Now, I remember, Rhoda, that you read a novel, that you did not read the novel, but a novel was read by Mani to Baba,
yes.
And it was called The
Three Gnomes.
The Three Gnomes.
Yes.
Now, these gnomes were named, what were the names of the gnomes?
Baba used to make me.
No, but what were the names of the gnomes? Bald Mani.
Yes.
Bald Mani was one.
Baba used to make me repeat the names of those gnomes. And I always used to forget them. So one day, women tried to prompt me, and I said the two names. But the third one, I couldn't. So Baba just put his hand on his bald head and said that this. And this, that is money.
Bald money.
Bald money.
Bald.
And still I couldn't remember the name.
And yet Rhoda was so much in love with Baba that she forgot the name and only remembered Baba. Is
and
that
they
right?
All had such laughs.
Oh, different names. Bald money, this money, that money. But the idea was
These were the names of the people.
Yes, the
yes,
gnomes.
Small three gnomes.
The
they
gnomes.
Were, they were very small.
In the novel that was read to Baba.
It was in the German book.
Anything else, Mervan? Yes.
This again happened in the summer of some 1960s at Guru Prasad. Baba, for some time, on his side table, he had a pink color plastic ball, a hollow pink color plastic ball. And what happened is that we used to sit in front of Baba in a semicircle. So he would occasionally throw the ball at anyone, unawares, and that person had to catch the ball. This was a very good way of keeping people sitting in front of Baba awake and fully conscious and alert, yes. A queer thing I would like to mention is that in Baba's presence, I always used to feel very sleepy. And especially in the afternoons, after the heavy meal, I would occasionally keep on dozing. And Baba would hit a ball right on the front forehead, and this would startle me, you see. Baba says, keep your eyes away, keep your eyes open, keep your eyes open. What have you eaten? That would be the question. Well, that same time, I also remember, he asked one lady who had come, and she had come the previous evening. And Baba, the first thing that Baba asked her the next morning was, did you sleep well? So that lady grumbled, no, Baba, I couldn't sleep well. There were a lot of mosquitoes and I couldn't sleep at all. I couldn't sleep properly at all. So Baba said, how fortunate you are. You had the whole night to think of me. Did you think of me? So she said, no, Baba. So Baba said, you thought of the mosquito, you thought of so many other things, but you didn't think of me. How sad. That was the story.
Well, Mervan and I are doing the talking. What are you all supposed to be doing? Looking pretty, that's all? Then I think I will tell you a story of how I used to go with the others, even Baba, of course, for a walk in the garden. I forget the name of the garden. But there were several new people there, and Baba, to please them, of course, and to draw their love, used to call them and catch hold of their hands and go on start and walk with them. Sometimes I used to be the person who used to help Baba. So this time I fell back and thought to myself, today Baba is rather busy with new people. Now what am I going to do? When will I get the chance to hold Baba's hand? So immediately, the minute I thought this, Baba did that and said, where is Jimmy? He used to say G is when he wanted to call me. And I said, oh, look, what a bad thought I had. And now Baba has read my mind, he has called me. He caught hold of my hand, looked at me in a very sweet, considerate way, and pleased me also. He pleased each and every individual that was with him. He was the person that looked after the feelings of all, young, old, new, and the very, very old Baba lovers. So shall we now put a stop to this? Shall we carry on? Rhoda, if you have done, you start singing the aarti.
Soon, you can remind her in English whatever you want.
I wanted to say something about the aarti.
Yes, come on.
Sir, speaking about the aarti, one day Surab Rustam and I were sitting before Baba, and Baba suddenly said, recite the aarti, Gujarati aarti. So I thought that Rustam might be knowing the complete aarti. I knew the aarti, but I needed guidance, a little guidance here, a little guidance there. So I thought Surab Rustam must be knowing the aarti. So, and Surab Rustam did not know also. They also knew the aarti, but they needed guidance. And they thought I knew the aarti. So we started very boldly. We started singing the aarti. And halfway, I went wrong and they followed me. So then I jumped from one paragraph to the fourth, and then from the fourth to the second, from the second to the last, and then the third. So Baba. Well, once a Baba lover asked Baba, Baba, why don't you make all of your lovers presidents, kings, and prime ministers, so that if they love you, then their followers, their citizens, the whole country, all the countries of the world will become Baba lovers. Why don't you make us presidents and kings? So Baba said that you don't realize how very fortunate you are, because his exact words were that if I had my way, I would even strip you of your underwears. Baba said, leave aside becoming a king, a president, and a prime minister, if I had my own way, I would strip you of your underwears. So
leave aside the trousers.
Yes. So this is what Baba said. Yeah. Well, another story. Well, it's not a story actually. Well, when such talk was presented before Baba, on several occasions, Baba lovers would quarrel amongst themselves and quarrel very vigorously. Except it would not be a hand-to-hand fight, but very vigorous fights. Oral abuses and whatnot. So Baba would then very sadly listen to everything, and then at the end of it would tell them that, look what has happened. I am the highest of the high, have descended to the lowest of the lowest levels, and is sitting before you and listening to your quarrels. This is what he said. Listening to your quarrels, I have the burden of the universe on my head, and as if you, to add on to that, you are presenting me with your quarrels and in front of me. And then he would tell them that, do not forget that I am God. Your familiarity with me makes you forget that I am God. So this he would tell his lovers. The familiarity with Baba would make them forget that Baba was God, and they would start quarreling in front of Baba. So Baba would then remind them that, do not forget that I am God.
Well, this is another incident that the boys want me to tell. Baba had called me to stay at Mehrazad for a month. And after Baba retired, we would sit out in the garden and start talking. So around, someone would start talking about snakes, vipers. Then someone would start about witches and ghosts. Then by that time, someone would start something else. So when I went to sleep at 9 o'clock, I was thinking about ghosts, vipers, snakes and everything. I couldn't sleep at all. So next day morning, my eyes were very red, and Baba noticed it, and he said, why, what's wrong? You didn't sleep? I said, no, Baba, I couldn't sleep. Why didn't you not sleep? Because Baba, I said, at 6 o'clock, they talk of ghosts. At 7, they talk of snakes. And by 8 o'clock, they start talking of witches. And that was playing on my mind all the time. So I could not sleep at all. I, of course, was not very serious. I was just joking to make Baba laugh. But Baba somehow then took it upon himself to see that a youngster around about 10 years of age, by the name of Ramu, he made Ramu sleep right next to me in the night. Now, Ramu would sleep very soundly. And that night, the kerosene lamp went off. I tried to light it. I had only one match left. That too I was not successful. So I passed a very nervous night the second night also. So again Baba said, what's wrong? You did not sleep well. I said, no Baba, I did not sleep well. This and this happened. So Baba had a hearty laugh. And our purpose, at least my purpose to go there, was not to carry sad tales to Baba, but to make him smile, make him laugh. So this way or the other, I succeeded somehow or the other. You have anything to add, Nargesh, on this topic of snakes?
tell them you was very frightened of the dogs.
There was a very ferocious bitch by the name of Guli. It's some kind of a semi-tigress, I suppose. And I used to keep a very safe distance from her. And practically from all dogs. Baba noticing that, told Kaka to bring Guli inside the men hall. I was there, and Guli at that time had some kind of a rash at the back, and she was always fed with an egg. So Baba called me and said, come here, now I want you to feed an egg to this Guli. The name of the bitch was Guli. So I said, Baba, you asked me to do something else, but not feed this, because I am mortally afraid. So Baba said, don't be afraid, come near. So I went near and I was practically like stoned there. I couldn't move my hands, my feet, nothing at all. Baba excused me from that feeding of the dog. I think I've spoken quite enough. Now.
All right.
Come along, hello. Come along. Param Rosh, Sar Rosh.
There's nothing to talk about.
So we'll take the opinion.
Yeah, we will take it in our room.
Okay, now the Westerners, how you help them?
When the Westerners came to India, we were volunteers and helped them carry on the 7 days darshan program which were held at Guru Prasad. I was greatly impressed by these young boys and girls who had never met Baba before, and it is really miraculous how they, in spite of their not seeing Baba once, were carried and felt Baba's love and presence, and it was indeed really creditable that they, being so new, had so much of love for Baba. And we, the old lovers of Baba, or so-called old lovers of Baba, had, in comparison, gained so little. And
yes.
This was Baba's miracle.
How the performance?
How he made his presence
perfect. Yes. There was something. Well, it was always so good hearing what they had to say, and these, the experiences that they had and how they came to Baba. And it was so different from what we really expected, and was very much greater and on a very great scale. And what we see today and hear today, that it's been this, that Baba lovers have been increasing every year by the thousands in America. I think it's very good. And that's not the case here, but I expect it should be in a short time.
We were fortunate to see Baba's manifestation in that sense.
I'd like to mention a point that whenever we were in the presence of Baba, and whether it was in the morning or however fresh we were, and whenever we were in his presence, it was always that we found ourselves a little more... we felt as if we were a little sleepy and drowsy. Very drowsy and very heavy.
And
by the time we left, we really felt tired, though we did nothing, just sitting there. And I clearly, distinctly remember this. And
we'd go to a hotel.
Baba's presence.
Yes. And it was. And whenever we, the minute we left the left Baba and went to our hotels, and we, the next thing we did was go to sleep.
You were that tired.
Yeah, very tired.
Mm-hmm. But this is not the only case. Yours was not the only case I remember. Very many old lovers of Baba also have told me, and I have also felt that, that power that you are not able to bear, and you feel your eyes shutting down as if you can't keep them open. Baba, of course, would go on with his fingers trying to keep you alert. But yours is not the only case. Many people have felt that way.
My brother Dara, whenever he came from Baba,
after taking his darshan, he always was laid up with fever and in bed completely. It was so always, without exception. Whenever he came from Baba's darshan, he was so tired and had fever.
But that wasn't with everybody.
No, that's an exception. But you know, means Baba's presences felt so strongly for with some people like that. I even remember one. He was one who had very not much of a chance to come and see at Guru Prasad, Baba, to see Baba at Guru Prasad. And one day I was just sitting on the gallery and thinking about it, that how unfortunate that he couldn't come. He wanted to come very much. So Baba called me in the room and just didn't say anything and says, you know, out of all you people, Dara loves me the most. His love is deep. He never shows it. I said, yes, Baba. That's all.
He just answered my question.
The darshan was something quite different from what I expected. Very frankly, I expected the Americans to come. First of all, I expected old Americans to be coming, like the ones in the 1964 East-West Gathering. 62 East-West Gathering. Most of them were old Baba lovers. And that is what I expected. But to my very great surprise, it was just the opposite. The old were the exception. And it was just a flow of new Baba lovers, 14, 15, 16, and all these young Baba lovers. And from the very beginning, from the airport itself, their love for Baba began to manifest. In the first place, their bags were plastered with pictures of Baba. As soon as they got down from the plane, they shouted out, Jai Baba, at the airport. I mean, non-concerned about the other people around. And as soon as they got into their buses, they started singing about Baba. This I had never seen before, and naturally it stirred up something which I can't tell you here. So I said, what is this type of love? I've never seen. Yes, their love is absolutely dynamic. It's active. It's not something passive. Like, we say we love Baba, but then what have we got to show for that love? Yeah, their love shows in the form of music, their love shows in the form of dances or something or the other. And then, of course, their performance at Guru Prasad, something which I had not dreamt of even. And that is the time when I recall Baba's words, that he said that there will come a time when my new lovers will tide over the old one, and the old ones will be way behind, will be driven back. The new lovers will come. It's something like what Christ said. And their love for Baba was, I mean, it required no, it was very evident. You didn't have to prove it. It was very evident. It was absolutely dynamic. But the thing that impressed me most also was that hardly a few of them had seen Baba. So I started to wonder that people who have not seen of Baba, just heard of him, and if they could love Baba so much, then what is our love? I mean, we have been in Baba's presence for 20 years, but what have we got to show for that? And the answer was absolutely zero. We have nothing to show of our love for Baba. Whereas these youngsters have managed to bring their relatives, their friends, and they have come in 3 chartered planes.
And at a great personal sacrifice.
Yes, and at a great personal sacrifice.
Because I know of stories.
I have been told of stories where people had to make tremendous financial and physical sacrifices to come from there to here, which I am sure very few of the Easterners would do, to travel only 100 or 200 miles.
I mean, you said that my children have remained hungry and have come here.
And The only thing that now I can say about this, that I recollect what Christ said, that blessed are those who have not seen and yet believe it. So this is the only statement which used to come before my mind all the time, that blessed are those who believe, who have not seen. Blessed are those who have not seen and yet believe it. So this is the statement which all the time used to come into my mind. And I remember that I told the statement to a Jewish Baba Lama on the train back, on the journey back to Bombay.